words, we are in fantasy land. We're in the lull before the storm, and it's going to splatter all over. I don't know when, but it can't be much longer.
One of the things that's happened is the central banks, Fed plus the ECB plus the BOJ, pumping a lot of liquidity into the global marketplace, which now is coming off gradually.
Yeah.
Can we take that liquidity back out and get to whatever normal is? I don't know what it is anymore, but if we get to normal without really cratering the stock market.
That's the great question. That's the fundamental question. And I think the answer is there is symmetry in the financial process. If repression, taking the interest rate down to zero for 9 years running, unheard of, or taking the long-term rates in Europe down to, you know, 30 basis points, or Japan 10 basis points, actually stimulated economic activity, then when you go in the opposite direction, it's going to unwind. In other words, the idea that there's asymmetry here, that we could push the rates down arbitrarily and make things better, but when we finally normalize, nothing's going to happen, is really, I think, wishful thinking.
Well, assuming, as you suggest, that we are heading to a downturn, maybe even worse than a downturn because of what's happened, are we better prepared for this time? We're coming up with the 10th anniversary now of the great financial crisis. Banks have a lot more reserves, but are we actually still exposed because of the non-banks, because of the BlackRocks with $6 trillion now?
Yeah, I agree, because it's not the banks. I don't think it was then. It was Wall Street. But there's $15.2 trillion of debt on the household sector. They didn't delever one bit in the last 9 years because the Fed pushed interest rates so low that there wasn't any incentive to pay down debt. Now, here's what's going to happen. 170 basis point average increase in interest rates, mm-hmm. let's say over 2 or 3 years, on the household sector would add $250 billion of interest expense to household budgets. How big a number is that? It's the same size as the annual tab for motor fuel and gasoline in the entire United States. Now, if you think that is going to have an impact, I think you're dreaming. Secondly, this phony tax cut that Trump put through is front-loaded. It's crazy. The first year, $200 billion of cuts. By 2022, it's down to maybe 1% of GDP. By 2 years later, we're actually raising taxes. So the fundamental point is, interest expense is going way up for everybody. Taxes are going up for the whole household sector, 155 million taxpayers. And when those things hit a economy that's this old, I mean, it's long in the tooth, we're 9 months from a record expansion, I think all hell's going to break loose.
The rationale right now is that
Man, he is so right, and I highly recommend, he has a YouTube channel you can follow. So I would highly consider checking out his YouTube channel. He worked for Ronald Reagan, David Stockman. So really smart guy. And like I said, this is why I'm investing in the crypto market. Now, I'm not fire selling my stocks and putting everything in crypto and doing YOLO, but I do think there's going to be a change. Crypto will stay down. Crypto might be down for another 6 months or however long, but eventually the stock market and the bond market will come down after all this funny money has to leave and stop pumping. And people are going to look for other assets that are more attractive, that are not controlled or not influenced as much by central bank lending. And crypto, commodities is that asset class. So let me know what you guys think about this, and I will talk to you guys soon.